So this is the next problem that we need to solve of compass surveying. These are the data that were observed during a compass surveying. Just like the earlier problem that we have solved, we need to find out if there is any local attraction present in any of these lines. And if there is any local attraction present, then just like the previous problem, we need to find out the corrected forward bearing and corrected back bearings. And there's one more step to it, that the magnetic declination is also given. So after we find out the corrected forward bearings and back bearings, just like we did in the local attraction problem, from those corrected forward bearings and back bearings, we need to find out the true bearings. How will we find out the true bearings? The expression I have just given yesterday in the last video, true bearing is equal to magnetic bearing plus or minus the magnetic declination. If the magnetic declination is west, then minus. So here in the given question, the magnetic declination is west, so this will be minus. Magnetic bearing will be the corrected bearings that we find out, okay, after we solve for local attraction. And from those corrected forward bearings and back bearings, we'll have to minus this magnetic declination to find the true bearings, okay. So let's try to solve this problem. So in order to solve this problem, first of all, we need to prepare this chart. Just like the previous problem, line, forward bearing, given forward bearing, given back bearing. We need to find out the error, then apply correction, corrected forward bearing and back bearing. Then this comes the new part, magnetic declination. So from this forward bearing and back bearing, we need to plus or minus this magnetic declination to find out the true bearing, true forward bearing and true back bearing. And this is the remux column. So let's start the problem. So first of all, we'll solve it for local attraction. I think you already know how to solve it for local attraction. First of all, we'll find out in which line the difference between the forward bearing and back bearing is the perfect 180 degree, plus or minus. So we have found out that only in this line PQ, the difference between forward bearing and back bearing is 180 degree. So in this line PQ, the error is 0. The correction is 0, and the corrected forward bearings and back bearings are the given corrected forward bearings and back bearings. So hence in the remux column we can write stations P and Q are free from local attraction. Okay, that means station P and Q are free from local attraction means all the readings taken from station P and Q are correct. So let us check the other lines if there is any station P and Q. So this is line QR. In the line QR, this is the reading taken from station Q. So this reading is correct. And in the line SP, this is the reading taken from station P. So this reading is also correct. Okay, so this is this given back bearing is correct. So under the corrected back bearings, we can write the same value, 89 degree 20 minutes. So when we have this, we can easily find out this is less than 180 degree. So we'll have to add 180 degree to this to find out this, the corrected forward bearing. Okay, let's do that. And the value comes out to be 269 degree 20 minutes. This is the incorrect forward bearing and this is the corrected forward bearing. So what is the error? 270 degree 20 minutes minus 269 degree 20 minutes. Okay. So error is plus 1 degree and correction will be minus 1 degree. At which station? This is what, which station? This is reading taken from station S. So at station S. So now we know what is the correction that needs to be applied at station S. It is minus 1 degree. So in the line RS, this is the reading taken from station R and this is the reading taken from station S. Okay, so now we know what is the correction that needs to be applied at station S. It is minus 1 degree. So the correct back bearing of 9 RS is equal to the given back bearing is 341 degree 10 minutes. RS 341 degree 10 minutes minus what is the correction at point S? Minus 1 degree. So minus 1 degree. This comes out to be 340 degree 10 minutes. So this comes out to be 340 degree 10 minutes. This is the correct back bearing of line RS. So correct back bearing is 340 degree 10 minutes. So when we have this, we can easily find out this. As this is greater than 180 degree, we will reduce 180 degree from this to find out this, just like the earlier problem. And this comes out to be 160 degree 10 minutes. If you have any problem, I'm writing it down. The correct forward bearing of line RS will be equal to, what is the correct back bearing? 340 degree 10 minutes minus 180 degree. Why minus? Because this is greater than 180 degree, that's why minus. If this would have been less than 180 degree, then it would have been plus. So after doing this, we got 160 degree 10 minutes. So 160 degree 10 minutes, this value we are putting here. So this is the given forward bearing and this is the corrected forward bearing. What is the error? Given minus corrected is the error. So this minus this, we got minus 40, minus 0 degree 40 minutes. This is the error. So the correction would be plus 0 degree 40 minutes. At which point? At point R. At point R. Now let us move to this line QR. Again, this is correct reading. We have already found out. This is correct reading because this is taken from station Q, and P and Q are free from local attraction. So 109 degree 20 minutes is the correct reading. So let us write 109 degree 20 minutes. So again, there's two ways to find out. When we had this, then it is very easy to find out this. This is less than 180 degree, so all we need to do is add 180 degree to this. Or we can apply this correction at R. This is the reading taken from station R. We can apply this correction also at this point to find out this, or we can simply add 180 degree to this to find out this. So let's find out what is the value of this corrected back bearing. So the value comes out to be 289 degree 20 minutes. Okay, so all the bearings are solved here. Here you apply. If you want to write the correction, then you can write the same correction. Plus 0 degree 40 minutes at R. Because this is the reading taken from R. 280 degree 40 minutes plus 0 degree 40 minutes at R is equal to 289 degree 20 minutes. Okay. So what is the magnetic declination given? It is 2 degree 40 minutes west. So when this is west, then we'll have to deduct this value 2 degree 40 minutes from all of these corrected bearings to find out the true bearings. And if this would have been east, then we would be adding this value to this. But now this is west, so we will be deducting this value of 2 degree 40 minutes from each and every of these angles to find out the true forward bearing and back bearings. These are the corrected forward bearing and back bearings. And after deducting 2 degree 40 minutes from each of these values, we will be getting the true forward bearings and back bearings of all the points. So let us come to this one. 36 degree 10 minutes minus 2 degree 40 minutes will be 33 degree 30 minutes. 216 degree 10 minutes minus 2 degree 40 minutes is equal to 213 degree 30 minutes. Just like that, we will solve for the other bearings also. So in that way, we'll solve for all the bearings. Okay, just like 269 degree 20 minutes minus 2 degree 40 minutes, we get this. So we have solved this for all the points. So these are the true bearings, and that is your solution.